Well, let me quickly go to Abuja, where Hamza Lawal is there. If you look at the yearnings of a lot of young people, you are a co-convener of Not Too Young to Run. But as it stands right now, if you heard what Professor Muhalu said, he said, look, we cannot afford to have those who do not, or someone who do not understand economics into president next time, that is 2019. Do you think that is perhaps a major criteria for us to have a president in 2019?
Oh, definitely. Because the world is now moving into innovation. And of course, as a president, one of your crises or one of your issues you want to tackle is creating jobs. And if you don't understand basic economics, then you cannot create sustainable jobs for teeming unemployed young people that we have today. But beyond just economics, you also need some level of background. What have you achieved? What are your antecedents? We need to understand what you have achieved. Have you actually created jobs that you want, have you created jobs before now, before you want us to elect you into office? So again, just to also buttress the point that before you use the power of your thumb, you actually need your PVC. And without that PVC, you can't use that power of the thumb. But I'm glad that, and it's quite exciting that we've seen that competition now. A lot of people now aspiring and becoming candidates. But we also need to understand that based on our constitution, they need to come through a process, which is political parties. So again, we're seeing new faces. We're seeing people who want to run for the highest office of the land. But then have they identified with the party? And what also is the ideology behind that party? Because this is what would sway voters. And mind you, this in 2019, we're going to have a new set of voters, which is the new millennia, people who have never voted in their life, who are really eager and excited to go and get registered to vote. So it's going to be a competitive political space in 2019, which is exciting.
I'm quite excited. Good for our democracy. Sorry if I may quickly butt in, because you just touched on the trajectory that is very interesting to me, but not very commonplace in our political climb here. And is the fact that the politics of ideologies, the politics of issues, where you find people contest based, or people are being elected based on the ideologies they hold. We see this play out a lot in some advanced democracies. And so the millennials that you're talking about, and the issue that we have seen in the past, where people, the crop of people who voted, who vote, for example, the 25 million of the 68 million registered voters in 2015 are perhaps not the elites, who are only in the corridors of their rooms and their houses, on their mobile phones, on Twitter and on social media, who will not go out. What do you think will be the issues or the major ones for 2019?
Well, for 2019, we'll be looking at people who would manage our resources. Over time, we always dwell on management of resources, but now it's all about mobilizing resources, because now we're experiencing a crisis with the dwelling of oil price. But then this millennial are looking at, would this person create a sustainable job for me? I'm always on my smartphone as a young person. How can he ensure that being on my smartphone would also create a job for me? How can I ensure that I can actually connect with the global economy and also ensure that it's more competitive? Is the infrastructure in place? The new millennial are looking at, can I access healthcare? Is there an incentive for education? Is there an incentive for access to quality water? And of course, you've mentioned that the over 20 million people that voted are actually at the grassroots. And the people at the grassroots are now wiser. They're no longer, they're not about the money bags. So when you take your money back to them, they're wiser. They will collect, but they will still vote for the people they trust and they believe in that would bring them sustainable development over time. And mind you, we're hearing, and as you've mentioned, the thought force. But the true thought force are young people. 52% of eligible voters registered by INEC are young people. So what other thought force are we talking about, if not for young people who can actually sway and decide who becomes the president of Nigeria?
We've been talking about political ideals now. Let's talk about political realities. The issue, quickly before we go on the break, the issue will be, political structures are very important in winning elections. I mean, that's the reality. World over. I mean, political structures are very important. They would be the one to work for you. Donald Trump almost came to the limelight without those kind of structures. Okay. But he needed them. Those were the ones who did the footwork. With all of these people that we're seeing right now emerging without the mainstream political parties, how do you think this will play out?
In 1999... I bet you before the election, if you ask, 50% of Nigerians what PDP was, too many people knew about them until they were voted into office, and then they started. People are the structures, it is people that make up the structures, and so. You find that that's why people need to be involved in the process right from the grassroots. And so once you are involved in the process from the grassroots, you become part of the structures.
Is it political awareness that I'm talking about?
Let me give you.
If Nigerians have come to that level,
let me also quickly give you an
example. Awareness.
In 2007 or so, Labour Party was not a force to be reckoned with. It didn't have structures, but some people defected into Labour Party with the power of the thumb. People gave them mandate and they created structures.
Okay. I'll need to pause it for a moment because we need to take a break. But when we come back, I have my panel on the program and we'll be dissecting what happened in the internal politics of the ruling APC yesterday. Loads and loads of controversies trailing the decision of the neck of the party. What is the implication of that? That's next on the program, everyone. Join us again.